Well, Netflix under fire today after its decision to pull an episode of a comedy show that was critical of Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman and his alleged role in the killing of journalist Jamal Khashoggi. Now, officials from the kingdom complained after the episode of Patriot Act, hosted by comic Hasan Minhaj. Take a watch.
I am genuinely rooting for change in Saudi Arabia. I am rooting for the people of Saudi Arabia. There are people in Saudi Arabia fighting for true reform, but MBS is not one of them. And to those who continue to work with him, just know that with every deal you close, you are simply helping entrench an absolute monarch under the guise of progress, because ultimately, MBS is not modernizing Saudi Arabia. The only thing he's modernizing is Saudi dictatorship.
Well, now, Netflix has blocked that episode from streaming in Saudi Arabia. It's a decision that has prompted widespread outrage. And his colleague at The Washington Post calls the move, quote, outrageous. I'm going to bring in CNN business reporter Hadass Gold. She joins me from London. So, Hadass, what reason did Saudi Arabia give as to why Netflix had to take this down?
So, Pam, this episode originally actually aired in October. It was only in the last few weeks that Netflix says it received a request, a legal request, actually, from Saudi Arabia to remove this episode. And Netflix wanted to emphasize this was a legal request. It wasn't just a general request for them to remove it. And Netflix says that Saudi Arabian officials cited Article 6 of their anti-cyber crime law, which prohibits impinging on public order, religious values, public morals, and privacy. Now, there's a lot in that episode that I'm sure Saudi Arabian officials would not be happy about hearing, including that clip you mentioned where he goes off against MBS. But another issue in that episode that Hasan Minhaj talks about that likely drew the ire of the officials in Saudi Arabia is him talking about how Saudi Arabia is home to some of the holiest sites in Islam. And Hasan Minhaj said that we access God through Saudi Arabia, a country I feel does not represent our values. So he's pretty much doubting whether Saudi Arabia should be in charge of these really religious sites. That probably contributed to this, but we don't have more details necessarily on exactly what in that episode Saudi Arabia officials were not happy with, because there's actually another follow-up episode just a few weeks ago that Hasan Minhaj released where he goes even harder related to the Khashoggi killings, and Netflix confirmed that that episode is still up and still available in Saudi Arabia.
So we should point out also, Hadass, that the episode has 1.4 million views already, at least double what his usual episodes get on YouTube. What else is Netflix saying as to the criticism that they are caving to the Saudis on this?
Pam, it's a great point that this controversy is actually likely giving Hasan Minhaj and this specific episode even more publicity. And you have to combine that people in Saudi Arabia can probably get around this ban. They can use VPNs to make it look like they're coming from somewhere else. And Netflix pointed out that so far that original episode, the one that was taken down, is still actually available on YouTube in the country. But Netflix is saying in a statement that they strongly support artistic freedom worldwide and only removed this episode in Saudi Arabia after we had received a valid legal request and to comply with local law. A Netflix spokesperson said to me separately that, you know, they don't necessarily agree with this law, but in order to be able to really continue in the country, they had to remove this because it was a valid legal request sent to them, and that's why they took it down. But this is something a lot of tech companies, a lot of media companies are dealing with now, is that they want to be global, international companies. Think of Google in China and the controversy over that potentially censored search engine they wanted to release there, is that they have to contend with these laws in these countries that don't necessarily comport with what these companies stand for when it comes to things like freedom of expression, freedom of speech.
And of course, the interpretation of the law in Saudi Arabia could be disputed. All right, Hadass Gold, thank you very much for bringing us the latest.
Thanks.
There.